Welcome to our weekly updates from Little Baby Bump, a mom and baby health center in BTM Layout, Bangalore. Here our eminent doctors give you tips on topical issues every week.
Uma, hi, welcome. She's actually a postgraduate in diet and nutrition, and she's a consultant at Little Baby Bump, the center. And today we are here to talk about the related diet and nutrition requirements of PCOS, right?
Yeah.
Do you want to just elaborate a little bit more on that, Uma?
Yes. PCOD is it is called as a polycystic ovarian disease, or even called as a syndrome. It is, than calling it as a disease, it is like a combination of many symptoms, which in future may cause metabolic diseases like diabetes and overweight, obesity, all those complications in later life. So the main problem is it starts in early adolescence, and many people might not even come to know they have the problem unless and until they get the problems with the infertility and all. So the common symptoms are overweight and facial hair and all those things, and they don't get their periods normally, irregular periods and all. Sometimes they don't even get their periods for 2-3 years. That time they'll come and see the gynec, and that time they get to know that the problem is there. So then diet-wise, if you see, the major concern is reducing their weight. When they have this PCOD problem, because of the hormonal imbalance and all, they'll have difficulty in reducing their weight. But of course, if you don't take care now, later on life is going to cause more problems. So definitely we have to sit and talk to them and make major diet changes and all, so that they will not put on too much weight. But of course I say it is very difficult to reduce the weight, especially when they have the PCOD problem, because of the insulin resistance and all those things. But definitely diet control and exercise keeps a major role in controlling the problem.
And what kind of diet should you recommend for them? Are there any, can they do something sitting at home?
Yeah, definitely. Weight reduction is the main goal. So as all of you know, you have to cut down on junk foods and sugars and all those things. Definitely, depending upon the individual cases, we'll see their dietary recall, and according to that, we'll do some changes in their diet. Mm-hmm. Plus some effective exercise and all will help in do magical things in their diet.
Are there any good foods or any bad foods that you would like to
eat? Food in the sense antioxidant-rich foods bright colored fruits, vegetables, all those things are definitely better. Mm-hmm. And high fiber-rich food, which also helps to burn out the fat and all. So again, it depends upon their individual cases. No, we sit and plan the diet and do the change.
And of course, chocolates and rasagollas things are bad.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Uma. Really appreciate it. Appreciate your insight. Thank you, friend.
You are listening to our weekly video cast from Little Baby Bump, a mom and baby center in BTM Layout, second stage, Bangalore. To find out more, please visit lilbabybump.com or facebook.com/littlebabybump. Thank you very much for listening.